first heard that part of my training and preparation for church planting would be to have a coach, I was welcoming of it. I mean, I thought it was good, but there was a certain point where I was a little bit anxious about it. It's a very vulnerable thing, having to talk to people about what you're doing. As you're doing it, as you're trying to figure things out. And so I was a little bit anxious about it, but the reality was that once I started working with my coach, who's George Hart, great guy, it was a wonderful, wonderful thing that God used to guide me, that he used to ground me, that he used to concretize things in my head to give me focus and direction. So it was a wonderful thing where I've been used to having focus and direction come out of my personal time with God and talking to certain people, but then having this regular relationship where that's blossoming all the time was an unexpected benefit of the coaching relationship for me. So George and I talk every month. We have a designated time where we have a phone conversation, and it usually lasts about an hour. And during that time, first we talk about our personal lives. I hear about the work that he's doing in his church, and I tell him about us and my family, and we talk about families because, you know, if there's not a personal bond there, it just doesn't work. If I don't like him, and if I don't know him, if I don't feel that he cares about me more than just as a church planter, it's going to be really hard to interact. So that time is very important that we spend at the beginning of each session. And then I give a little bit of an update about where things are, decisions that we've made, activities that we're going to undertake, and just any changes, significant changes that have taken place. And then what he will do after I finish is he reminds me of all the things that I said I was going to do, because he just does not forget. But I really appreciate that, because he'll bring up things. He says, well, last time you said X, Y, and Z, and I'll just rub my chin. It's like, oh, yeah, I did. and that's something I need to make progress on. And so what it does is there's so much happening all the time with the church plant. There's this momentum and this pace that develops where you're constantly going. And it's good to take a step back and take stock in, okay, these are the things that we said were important and said that we wanted to do, and make sure that we're actually doing those things and taking care of what's important. One of the things that George and I talk about the most is the population that we're trying to reach. In Randolph, we have a very unique community, very diverse. And so we talk about those people that we're trying to touch and trying to reach, and we talk through a lot of strategies. And we talk through about what I'm seeing and how that's changing our plan and how that's causing us to rethink certain things. And so I think where he's been the most helpful is helping me unlearn and deconstruct some of the preconceptions that I had about the community that I live in. I mean, I live there, but even now I'm learning more and more about that community. And because he's not there, because he's an outsider, he can ask me certain things and ask me to talk about things in a different way that just would not occur to me because I'm so in it. I've learned that I'm not going to be immune from discouragement. It's going to be something that is always a temptation, is always something that's there. And myself personally, I would often just internalize that and just deal with things on my own. I wouldn't really talk about it. I wouldn't talk about my fears. I wouldn't talk about my anxiety. I would just kind of hold that in. And that's not healthy. It's not a good way to be. But what I found is that in talking about some of the things that I've been experiencing and going through, God just speaks so clearly through George right to me, where I'm able to hear his voice so much more clearly. Because I know George is someone that cares about me, but he also has a lot of experience and a lot of wisdom to share to help a young church planter like me. And so there have been times where I've said to him, you know, I've had a rough week this week, you know, or this was a rough period. A lot of things didn't go right since our last call. And he just helps me get perspective. You know, there's always this temptation to look at numbers. There's always this temptation to measure success in a way that God does not measure success. And he helps to bring me back. I come from a sports background. If a coach doesn't like what you're doing, they tell you drop and do 25, and they're very directive, very authoritarian. And, you know, I didn't know if I was going to get a coach that was going to be coming to sort of whip me into shape. And I did not need that in my life. You know? But what he does is he just very gently asks me questions and suggests things. And so it makes me want to call him. It makes me want to talk with him. Versus if he was holding things over me and telling me I'm not doing a great job here and there, you know, I really wouldn't want to connect. So I think what I appreciate the most is the approach that my coach takes to, in some ways, guide me, to mentor me. But he always has this very objective lens where he's never judging. I never feel judged by him for anything that I do. It's really just taking the posture of he's there to help me do what God has told us to do. And he really just affirms that all the time with the things that he says. And so that having that kind of person in my life helping me do this work just is so important and just such a blessing.